Mark, in all those features that are now available in Visual Studio 2022 and to help and boost the productivity of the developer, I heard of hot reload. So I come prepared, as you can see, but can you explain a bit more?
Yeah, I think hot reload kind of unlocks the true kind of productivity potential of developers. Much problem, even more so than only the other features we've talked about. I love hot reload because it kind of allows us to kind of think about our edit and development cycle in a much smaller time frame. So, for example, if I am currently editing or diagnosing a particular issue, or I'm maybe adding something to a new WinForms app or some kind of other application, I might want to just see how the impact occurs without necessarily having to stop my entire application, recompile, and kind of build and start the whole process again. That kind of rebuilding process really adds minutes, seconds, hours over the course of an entire day. And so the work we've done with Hot Reload is to reduce that kind of edit and see what I'm doing kind of time frame. And let me just kind of show you a couple of examples what I mean for that. I think maybe showing you is going to be a bit easier than explaining to you. So I've got this very basic. This is the scaffolding of a new ASP.NET application, right? Just the normal stuff you'd expecting here. It's got a H1 welcome. It's got a paragraph in here, and over here is that page. So if I refresh that, this is essentially giving me the results of this index CHTML. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to add a little bit more code. So this CSHTML is a mixture of HTML and compiled code. So actually, what I'm going to do here is I've just pasted in this new text here, and I've in the line, I've put the at symbol, which means I'm going to, after this line, it's going to be some code. And I want to get the OS version, which will be the OS version of the development machine I'm using. I want to know if this is a 64-bit operating system and a process. Now, normally, I would have to do a bit more work here. I probably have to stop to kind of get this work compiled because I've already built my application and it's running over here, right? But I'm just going to go ahead and hit save on this here. And if you noticed in this area here, Hot Reload has just wanted to tell, let me just zoom in there. Hot Reload has just zoomed in and said, I'm sending updates to the running application that you're debugging right now. And I'm also going to up, it's also letting me know that it's updated and applied those updates to the application. So now when I refresh the page over here, the additional information I've asked for is immediately there. I haven't stopped my application. I haven't paused or edited my application. It just knows Visual Studio with the framework knows exactly what to do with my changes now. And that's all to do. If you look at this new icon we have here, control, I'm just going to zoom in here. We have this hot reload icon right here. And that is means that hot reload is enabled for this project and any changes that it can manage to apply, it will just go ahead and apply them to my running application. So now I don't have to stop it. I don't have to pause it. I don't have to do any of those things to evaluate this scenario. I can have this continuous cycle of editing, verifying, without having to worry about stopping my application. And I think developers will know instinctively that will do a lot to ensure that we are much more productive.
Yeah, because sometimes the solution or if the just a project could be long to compile, so now just you're saving that, correct?
That's exactly right. I think the amount of time we spend with our rebuild, because we have these
Oh, yeah.
extravagant, huge projects, and sometimes build times are in the order of minutes, right? So now imagine us eliminating over the course of an entire day, over the course of an entire project, the amount of time we're spending just on the rebuild process. And I just want to actually do a little bit more, actually, because I want to prove to you that I'm not doing any magic here, right? So there's no magic things. This is actually really, we are not restarting the process for you at all. So I'm going to put it in another line. And in this line, I'm going to say managed thread. And I want you to know that this is the system diagnostics process. And I'm going to say get the current process ID, right? So I'm going to go ahead and hit save. So this is the new line I've added. And I'm going to wait for it. I think it's just successfully updated. I think this was the latest upload there. So I'm going to head and refresh my page now. And refreshing. Now it's telling me that I'm using managed thread 33316. Perfect, right? So if we would, if this were not correct, if I had to stop this, I just want to show you an example. If I stopped this, I would get a brand new thread because it would be a different process, right? But what I want to show you is that I am now able to come in here. This is no magic tricks at all. This is just really happening. I'm going to go ahead here, if I can type this correctly. This is the same process. Not quite spelled correctly, but I think we'll get the principle. Just save that. I'm going to make sure that hot reload. Yep, it's just sent the difference. So now our assumption here is that we should have the same ID here. So I'm going to go ahead and refresh. It's the same ID, but I'm going to make sure that's saved correctly. Make sure that's sent to the update. That sent the update and refresh, and there we go. Took a second for it to update, but here we have 331-33316. It's the same process ID. I haven't tricked you. This is if Visual Studio had restarted this, I'd have got a fresh new ID here. But this is the same process ID. What is going on in the background? The framework is able to say Visual Studio is able to hand just the delta of the code changes I made to the framework and say, hey, this is the difference between what you have and what I've just got. And the framework is able to really efficiently grab that difference and apply that while still running the process. It's really, really a fascinating stuff. It really applies to multiple situations. Obviously, this is an ASP.NET MVC application, but this could apply to, you know, WPF, WinForms, .NET MAUI, some native scenarios even, WinUI 3, all these scenarios are positively impacted here. And I absolutely love it because I think this is one of the game changers that are going to make us way more productive.
And I hear you talking about different scenario. I think you want to show us one more quickly. Am I right?
Yeah. So there's actually, so those developers out there that are focused on web front end, this actually works for you too. In fact, I think this is one of those things that Visual Studio has possibly lacked in the past, where if you wanted to make change to your HTML or CSS, you wouldn't see those immediate changes. So let's look at this particular page here. If I were to look at this welcome sign, in fact, this is what this welcome sign is, a H1 class here, a H1 tag, and there's a display for class associated with it, right? So actually what I can do here, just like developers, I can start to manipulate the CSS. And if you looked really closely there on the left, you would have seen the change happen occur immediately. I'm not, and just to be clear, I'm going to change that to one. Welcome's updated. See that? And if you notice, I haven't even.
Yeah, I was about to say, like, the status of the file didn't change yet.
Didn't change yet. Hot reload is understanding my intent here and immediately pushing my change straight over. So I get the chance to, I can be that kind of web developer fast, really fast iterations on design, which is another big part of development, right? So as you kind of experimenting with these design ideas, you can do so straight from Visual Studio and let Hot Reload kind of push those changes directly to your web UI.
Wonderful, thank you. And now let's go back to the chat.